friends. Most of the teachers think that teaching at early primary classes is very easy, and it includes teaching of numbers mainly. But, friends, here it is important to understand that mathematics does not include numbers only. Learning mathematics also includes understanding of different shapes and its various aspects like corners, edges, and surfaces in early primary mathematics. Keeping all these in mind and to provide such hands-on experience to each child, a very interesting and attractive learning item has been included in the mathematics learning kit. So this learning material is named as tiles. Let me show you. Let's see. Oh, these are so many. This learning material contains various shapes like triangle, circle, hexagon, rhombus, and square. And each shape is in three sizes and in three colors, that is red, blue, and yellow. Total number of tiles is 240, and the number of medium size shape is kept maximum for tessellation purpose. As you can see, we have classified this material according to different colors, sizes, and shapes. Like you can see here, hexagon shape in three different sizes of red color. And here, hexagonal shape of three different sizes in yellow color. And you can see the medium size is kept maximum for tessellation purpose. This material is made up of EVA rubber, which is very light. And for the child's safety purpose, it is non-toxic. Along with this, two trays have been included. One is hexagon in shape and the other is square shape for tessellation purpose. And the most interesting attribute of these shapes is that these shapes can stick to any surface with the help of water, like on the wall, floor, furniture, on iron, etc. Let me show you. So here I have water and I'm going to make a pattern with these shapes, sticking them using a little water with these different color triangles of same size. Let's see if I can stick them. I'm using just a little water and trying to make a pattern with different triangles. Let's see. Okay, I'll use red one. This is my kind of star using all the triangles. Let's see, are they sticked? Yes, it is. See? It's not falling. Let's go into the classroom and see with what children are playing.
Free play will allow the children to explore the different attributes of tiles, like colors, shapes, and sizes. children can be encouraged to share about on basis of which attribute they have sorted and classified the tiles.
Here we saw that how children got involved in the classification of tiles. Children classified the tiles first on the basis of color, then on the basis of shapes, and with the help of the prompting of questions by teacher, children further classified on the basis of sizes. To grasp all the aspects, each child may take time according to their own pace of learning. Some may be able to do the same in one day, others may take some more time to be able to see all the aspects of tiles. So, we need to be careful not to get impatient while a child is exploring. It becomes important that children get a lot of time for free play and exploration. For the children to construct knowledge and understanding of shapes, different activities in different contexts can be conducted in the classroom for some days. Friends, recognizing, describing, and then extending are the important aspect for the understanding of patterns. It is important that children are provided with material for free play and given enough time to explore. As thinking is a continuous process, children do think and try the same activity later at home or next day. This kind of exploration strengthens one's understanding, and that's how they construct their knowledge. A tessellation is created when a shape is repeated over and over again, covering a plane without any gaps or overlaps. A tessellation of triangles, I'll show you. Let me use yellow. This is how I'm creating a tessellation using triangles. Here only, I'll show you another tessellation of squares. Okay, this time I'll use blue. Okay, I'll show you in this tray. This was a tessellation of triangles, and now here we have a tessellation of squares. Okay, I'll use two colors. Oh, it's a beautiful pattern being made. This is how. Let's make another tessellation of hexagons. Okay. Let me take these bigger hexagons. And here if I arrange them, somewhat like this. Friends, when you look at these three samples, you can easily notice that the squares are lined up with each other while the triangles and hexagons are not. Also, if you look at six triangles at a time, they form a hexagon. So, the tiling of triangles and the tiling of hexagons are similar. Let's see. This is a bigger hexagon I have, and I'm arranging six triangles on this hexagon. So, six triangles overlapping the big hexagon, making a hexagon. So, the tiling of triangles and the tiling of hexagons are similar, and they cannot be formed by directly lining shapes up under each other. A slide is involved. Such activities will help them to to construct the knowledge about important aspects of shapes and also provides scope for creativity. Friends, we believe that you will be able to conduct much more interesting activities and thereby creating more lively environment for the learning in which each child is learning joyfully.